Senator Loeffler says that these latest allegations about Warnock are disqualifying, alarming, and disgusting. Does that pretty much sum it up?
Yeah, it definitely does. And look, you know, this is something that Senator Loeffler has been talking about for weeks. Here are the facts. Here's what we know. That in 2002, Raphael Warnock was arrested for obstructing an investigation into child abuse at a summer camp that he was running. Those charges were later dropped, but now we know more evidence. We have on-the-record statement from a victim saying that he was abused, just as you said, that they dumped urine on him and forced him to sleep outside. This should be automatically disqualifying. In fact, if this was a conservative that this was happening to, it would be wall-to-wall coverage from the mainstream media. But they are dead silent, and they are complicit in what's going on, and it's disgraceful. He needs to answer questions about this very serious allegation. What was his involvement? Did he know anything? I think it's very clear that he knew what was going on, because for 2 months, he's been ducking questions about this scenario, and I think it speaks to exactly what he knew was going on at this summer camp.
And of course, just earlier this year, we saw some police body cam footage that was released of Warnock's ex-wife, or now ex-wife, when she accused him of running over her foot during a heated argument that the pair had. And of course, you see Warnock telling police that he denied everything. But the ex-wife, when she speaks to officers, she says he's a great actor. He knows how to play the game, basically. And that's very scary. And the fact that the media is covering up for potential child abuse at the summer camp, a poor ex-wife talking about perhaps abuse that happened to her. Are you surprised at all that the media is memory holding all of this and not talking about it?
It's pretty astonishing. Look, we knew that the mainstream media, likes to cover up for Democratic candidates, likes to ignore things that are going on the left, likes to play double standard in a very hypocritical way. But this is a new level. This is astonishing, the level to which they are covering up for Raphael Warnock. Not just with child abuse, but now domestic abuse. But it follows a pattern of they've covered up his entire record, whether it's allegations, serious allegations of domestic abuse from his ex-wife washed away, serious allegations of child abuse at a summer camp that Raphael Warnock was running, washed away, support for Marxism, washed away, Fidel Castro at his church. Oh, that was just an anomaly. On and on and on. They are covering for this man, and it's really disgraceful. And if not for outlets like OAN and Newsmax and the conservative media, no one would know about this. I think that should scare every American. And I think we've all got to wake up and realize what the mainstream media is doing in this country.
And of course, knowing what we know now about Warnock, and you mentioned Marxism as well, what do you think that Senate Minority Leader Chuck Schumer a couple weeks back meant when he said, "We take Georgia, we change America"?
Well, I think you would have the two most radically liberal candidates anywhere in the country. I mean, let's look. I mean, these are not mainstream Democrats. These are not your typical Georgia Democrats, much less American Democrats. And John Ossoff, you have a trust fund socialist, never had a real job. He is bought and paid for by George Soros, California liberals, New York elites like Chuck Schumer and AOC. And in Raphael Warnock, you have someone who would be the United States' first Marxist senator. This is someone who has openly embraced Fidel Castro, Louis Farrakhan, James Cohn, Linda Sarsour. I mean, the list goes on and on. He makes Bernie Sanders look like a moderate, and the Democrats and the mainstream media are just going along and playing along to get along, and it's disgraceful. We have got to stand up. We've got to stand up quickly. The Democrats are mobilizing down here. We've got to listen to President Trump. He said it best. Every single Georgia Republican has to get out and vote. You've got to do it now. You've got to do it early. We have to overwhelm the system. We've got to shake the system on January 5th to make sure that America, the world, hears that Georgia is a red state, and we're not going to stand for what happened in November.